everyone, today we are going to learn how to find level order traversal of a tree. So this is the tree given and we have to find the level order traversal. And what is the level order traversal? We have to write all the nodes at all the levels. We have to start from the first level, then we have to print the nodes which are present in the second level from left to right, and then the last level. In the last level we have to print in nodes present in the tree. For example, in this tree the output is 10, then 20, 30, then 40, 60. The simple way is we can draw a line and then we can see from the last of the arrow till the starting point of the arrow. We have to traverse and then we have to write the output for manual calculation. And for the coding part, let's see. We will make a queue and then we will add the elements of the tree one by one in the queue. First element is 10. So I will add 10 here and then I will check whether the children of 10 are present or not. Yes, the left and right child of children of the root is present, 20 and 30. So we will push it into the queue. Now what we will do? We will pop the first element and we will write it in the answer. So after popping, 20 and 30 will come at first place. Now we will see 20. We will check whether 20 is having any children or not. Yes, 20 is also having 40 and 60. So we will add 40 and 60 into the queue. Now we will pop 20 and we will write it in the answer. We'll pop 20 and write it in the answer. Now for 30, we will check whether 30 is having any children or not. No, 30 is not having any children. We will simply pop it and write it in the answer. Now for 40 and 60 also, these two are not having any children. So we will simply pop it and write it in the answer. So after traversing the whole tree, we are able to find the output which is level order traversal using a queue. Now let's see the pseudo code. I have made a queue named Q. Then we are checking while Q is not empty. Then we are pushing the first node. We are making a node T and then we are pointing it to the first element of the queue, Q.front. And then we are pushing the data of the first node into the queue. Then answer variable we have to make at the first as 0. Then we are checking if T is left is present. Suppose this is T and T is pointing to the first. So if T is left is present, then we have to push it. If T is right is present, then we have to push it into the queue. And then we have to pop it. As the pop operation of the queue happens from the front, so it will always pop elements at the front side. So we are popping the elements of the queue and then finally we are returning answer. Because we are pushing the answer in the data of the node in the answer variable. So at final we will return answer and then we are able to get the output as the level order traversal. Now let's see the code part. See, I have made an answer variable vector because we have to make it like we will insert elements one by one. So it will be a dynamic array. So I have made a vector int of answer. Then we are checking if root is empty or not. If it is empty, then we will print it as the answer, because if nothing is there, so we cannot calculate the level order traversal. Now I have made a queue of node star type. The node star type is the structure given in the code that we cannot edit. Now we are checking. We are pushing the root node into the queue and then we are checking if the first node's children are present or not. T is left and T is right. And in T, we are storing the first element. that is pushed into the Q first. Q dot front means it will point to the first element of the Q that we have pushed here. Q dot push is root. So it will point to the first element. Note that T is equal to root. Now, like we are pushing the data part of the root, then we are checking and then we are popping one by one. Then we are returning the answer. Because in answer variable, we are one by one pushing the data part. So at last, it will print the whole array. Let's submit it. There's some error. Let's see. If not root, root was not declared. Let's run it now. Yes, it is successful. It is submitted. Now let's see the time and space complexity. Both are O of n. Because we are making a queue to store all the nodes of the tree. The time complexity is O of n. Because we are traversing the whole queue. And O of n because we are making a queue. And for time because we are traversing the whole queue. So it will take O of n time. So this was the time and space complexity. And that's all for this question. Thank you.